Are hydrogen-powered cars the future? Hydrogen fuel cell vehicles can solve the issue of range anxiety and are also an extremely environmentally friendly energy source. But are these vehicles the future of transportation? Let's find out. Over the past decade, there's been a growing move towards sustainable, environmentally friendly transportation. It's become obvious that the petrol and diesel cars are not only bad for the environment, but they're also not sustainable in the long term due to the finite fossil fuel reserves we have here on Earth. This has led to various entrepreneurs, billionaires, and car companies coming up with new solutions for future transportation. For now, it may seem that electric vehicles are the ideal candidates to replace the pollution-generating fossil fuel-based vehicles. But there's another dark horse in the race. It's the hydrogen fuel-powered vehicles. The concept of electric vehicles revolves around a central battery pack providing power to the electric motor. What this means is that the electric vehicles use the energy that's generated externally by wind turbines, solar power plants, nuclear power plants, and other types of power plants. Hydrogen-powered vehicles take a different approach. They don't require electricity generated from other sources. They can generate electricity on board. The technology's already been demonstrated, and there are already quite impressive hydrogen-powered vehicles available to consumers. Major car companies, including Honda, Toyota, and Hyundai, have invested heavily in the technology. Hydrogen-powered vehicles basically use hydrogen fuel for motive power. These vehicles have power plants of their own that convert the chemical energy of hydrogen to mechanical energy by reacting hydrogen with oxygen in a fuel cell to power the electric motors. Unlike dirty fuels like petrol and diesel, hydrogen does not produce any harmful emissions. It's environmentally friendly if produced in certain ways and is available abundantly. Up till now, most of the hydrogen, about 98% of it, is produced by steam methane reforming, which emits carbon dioxide. However, there's potential of producing it by using thermochemical or pyrolytic using renewable feedstocks. But that process is currently too expensive. Billions of dollars are being invested into developing technology that can produce hydrogen from other sources that cost less and provides more hydrogen than natural gas. One of the remarkable things about hydrogen power is that not only automobiles, buses, and trucks can run on it, but boats, airplanes, submarines, and even rockets can also run on hydrogen as well. The technology already exists. It's just a matter of bringing down the costs and making it more viable. Over the past few years, we've seen the car markets around the world being flooded by various electric vehicles and hybrid vehicles. Hydrogen-powered vehicles have also been introduced into a few markets. There are currently three hydrogen cars available in different markets. The first one is the Toyota Mirai. It's a mid-sized hydrogen fuel cell vehicle, or FCEV. It was unveiled back in November 2014. And according to recent stats, more than 10,000 units of Mirai have been sold. Most of these units have been sold in the US and Japan. The Mirai has a total range of 312 miles on a fuel tank and is the most fuel-efficient hydrogen fuel cell vehicle in the US. It can accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 9 seconds. However, during the past couple of years, the sale of Mirai have slowed down. Hyundai's iX35 FCEV is another hydrogen fuel cell electric vehicle that's available for the consumers in the US. It's the first hydrogen-powered SUV to be commercially sold. The latest version of the iX35 FCEV is known as the Tucson iX35 FCEV. It has a powerful electric engine rated at 100 kilowatts and has a range of about 369 miles on one full tank. The greater space for holding hydrogen tanks, higher storage pressure, and better fuel cell technology has allowed this vehicle to achieve greater mileage than the previous versions. Hyundai iX35 FCEV has not been as successful as Toyota Mirai. Only a couple hundred units of this vehicle could be sold in the markets where it's available. Recently, Hyundai launched another hydrogen fuel cell powered crossover SUV known as Hyundai Nexo. This vehicle was revealed at the 2018 Consumer Electronics Show on January 8, 2018. It's set to replace the Hyundai Tucson FCEV. Hyundai Nexo will have a range of about 380 miles. It will have three fuel tanks with a total capacity of 156 liters and 6.3 kilograms. Nexo is also equipped with new assistant systems, such as blind spot view monitor, lane following assist, and highway driving assist. While the crossover SUV does not have complete autonomous driving, it can maintain its lane autonomously by detecting lane markings or road edges. It can also automatically adjust speed to maintain a safe drive on highways. Lastly, we have Honda's answer to hydrogen-powered vehicles, the Honda FCX Clarity. This hydrogen fuel cell electric vehicle was launched in 2006, and it was phased out in 2014. Honda FCX Clarity had zero emissions and had only 5-minute refueling times. It had a total range of 240 miles. The vehicle could not get a lot of sales and was eventually phased out by Honda. The name Honda Clarity was later given to the new electric cars being made by Honda. If we take a look at all these hydrogen-powered cars being produced by some of the top car manufacturing companies in the world, it's kind of obvious that the idea of hydrogen-powered vehicles could not resonate well with the consumers. These cars could not bring in a lot of revenue for the companies, and the sale numbers were really low. One of the factors behind low sales of these vehicles was their high price. Also, the specs in these cars were not too tempting for most of the consumers to buy them. It has to be said that the electric cars have a huge advantage over the hydrogen fuel cell vehicles in utilizing low carbon electricity. The hydrogen fueling process is inherently efficient. The entire process involves generating hydrogen, transporting it long distances to hydrogen stations, then getting the hydrogen in the car, and then running it through a fuel cell. All this has to be done just for the purpose of converting the hydrogen back into electricity to drive the same electric motor that you find in an electric car. This raises the question, why not use the already existing electricity production and transmission network and directly use that electricity in electric vehicles? Why spend billions of dollars on creating entirely new infrastructure for hydrogen-powered vehicles that apparently do not enjoy any major advantage over electric vehicles? Furthermore, over the past few years, the cost of electric batteries has drastically come down. Also, you can pretty much charge an electric vehicle at your home, and according to some estimates, the cost of electricity is at least 75% cheaper than hydrogen. The idea of hydrogen-powered vehicles seemed quite interesting up until 2016-2017. However, as electric cars started becoming more mainstream and major issues like range anxiety were resolved in electric vehicles, the hydrogen-powered vehicles started losing the race. A few years ago, Elon Musk was asked to tell his opinion on the hydrogen fuel cell-powered vehicles. He responded by describing the idea of hydrogen fuel cells to be extremely silly. According to Musk, the major problem with hydrogen vehicles was that it was really difficult to make hydrogen, store it, and then use it in a car. He described hydrogen as an energy storage mechanism and made it clear that it wasn't a source of energy itself. Therefore, one had to get hydrogen from somewhere. Also, there are many other problems as well. For example, hydrogen has a very low density and storing it is a huge hassle. It's also extremely flammable, which is probably not something you want to add in an electrically motorized car. Musk had predicted that the debate of hydrogen fuel cell vehicles versus electric vehicles would be over very soon. And as time has gone by, it's become quite obvious that hydrogen fuel cell vehicles are just not viable for normal consumers. Now, does this mean the end of the road for the hydrogen vehicles? Well, this is kind of hard to predict. While it's quite obvious that electric vehicles are the future now, and the world will be shifting to electric vehicles within the next 2 to 3 decades, we may just see the rise of hydrogen fuel cell vehicles again, provided that there's a major breakthrough in their technology. But even if hydrogen fuel cell cars are not viable, there may be other uses for hydrogen fuel cells in transportation, such as in ships, airplanes, or rockets. What do you guys think about the hydrogen fuel cell vehicles? Would you buy one of these cars for yourself? Let us know by leaving a comment below. If you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay updated whenever we release a new video. Other than that, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.